they go on Instagram, it's gonna be like an off angle.
Yeah. Just some, maybe a little progress update, some things that I've noticed over the past week, and how putting together the health and fitness club is coming along. So, on with that first subject, I've noticed a huge jump in my bench performance. I'm not really sure what to attribute that to, but I think some of the principles of this training program are starting to really click for me. I think my form wasn't great to begin with. I was very used to focusing on hypertrophy movements and getting as many reps as I possibly could on dumbbell bench when I worked with chest. And bench in a powerlifting style to maximize strength, you really, I don't know, it's hard to fully grasp the technicality of the movement. It seems so simple, but it's really not. So I think I'm finally starting to understand the intricacies of bench more, and it's allowed me to improve. Same with squats. Squats, I feel like I'm using my whole body as opposed to just my legs to drive myself out of the hole. Nico was telling me to really engage the lats, really pull the bar into your back. And I think using that strategy has helped immensely. And with deadlift, I'm stagnating. It's really, really annoying. But I'm learning, I'm watching videos from all different sites to try to really hone that in. And that leads me to starting the Health and Fitness Club, because I've been trying to find these references online and learning how to do these things on my own. And even as a certified personal trainer, I find it difficult. So I can't imagine someone who's just starting out sifting through all this information. It's great that it's available, but it's so difficult to learn if someone's not there, right there with you. And that's why I think having a health and fitness club, a place where people can come to seek one-on-one training and have a personal touch to their fitness programming can help. So this week I've been brainstorming with some people that want to help start this, and we've reached a critical first step, and that's creating the mission statement and putting together something that looks professional and something we could present to the student government to have them, you know, have them move forward with us becoming a club and hopefully getting some funds. So what we put together is a list of things that we find are difficult when starting your fitness journey. And we thought of ways to remedy those. And as we went down the list, we found all of our solutions. And then we took those solutions and drafted them into a proposal. And I think, you know, it's a good way to start. It shows that we mean business, that we're gonna be professional about it, and that we have something tangible to offer the community. And I would say that when maybe if any of you are involved in that kind of thing, it's very, very important to believe in what you're doing, because then each step will make logical sense to you. If you were trying to convince someone to have you do some, have them do something for you, or have you, you know, work with them, you'd want to prove your stock. So that's what I learned this week. Sorry this video is coming out so late, but it's just been busy. A friend from home, Michael Barnett, is up for the weekend. He's visiting. He's out with some friends right now, giving him the old college experience. I really hope he's having fun. I know that I'm kind of boring to hang out with. He's been lamenting all weekend, but I think we've done some cool stuff. But yeah, other than that, if that's it for today. I know it was kind of quick, but tomorrow I'm going to throw together kind of what I eat in the day. I have a different viewpoint on nutrition than both Nico and Yanni. I abstain from meat and most animal products. I really try to stay away from that kind of thing. And I'll explain why in tomorrow's video. But thank you for watching. Any feedback is welcome. But you know, like, favorite, subscribe, that'd be super awesome. But if you don't want to do that, shoot us a question, shoot us an email, follow us on Instagram. You know, you can see us. You know, we usually post our lifts to the Strength Through Steel Instagram. So if you want to see our progress, you know, on that front firsthand, that's definitely where to follow us. But yeah, thank you for watching.